Okay, so now you've learned how to work with strings. Let's take a look at how we work with numbers inside our Python code as well. Just like strings, numbers can be stored inside variables. We always want to give those variables nice, meaningful names, get in the habit of that right away. And we can pass those variables into functions like the print statement. So the print statement can take a variable that contains a string, a variable that contains a number. It really doesn't matter either way. It'll just print what it's received up onto the screen. Of course, when you're working with numbers in your code, at some point you're probably going to have to do math. Calculations to figure out people's salaries or taxes and things are pretty common inside our code. So we can do math with the numbers, and the good news is it's going to look a lot like it did when you were in school. You've got the plus sign for addition, the negative sign for subtraction, you've got the slash for division, and then the only thing that's a little bit different is it's an asterisk symbol for multiplication, and an exponent, or to the power of, is a double asterisk. So if I have two numbers here, 6 and 2, 6 plus 2 prints out an 8, 6 to the power of 2, 6 squared, will give me back 36. So we can do lots of different math operations inside once we start playing with numbers. One thing you will run into very quickly once you start working with numbers is that when you start combining different data types, so a string data type and a number data type, Python will get confused. So in this case, I have, hey, how many days in February? 28. And then I just say, hey, print statement. Let's display on the screen, 28 days in February. And we've already printed numbers, we've already printed strings, yet when we run this code, it blows up. But why? Well, if you actually look at the error message, it'll give you a hint. Unsupported operand type for plus, int n string. What it's telling you is it's actually the plus symbol that's confused. 5 plus 6, it knows a number plus a number, I should be doing addition. Susan plus IBAC, two strings, it knows to concatenate the strings together. But when you give me one number, one string, am I supposed to add them together like numbers? Or am I supposed to concatenate them like strings? I'm confused. So when you're working with Python, sometimes you have to tell it, hey, I know that the days in February 28, in this case, is a number, but I want you to treat it like a string here. I want you to concatenate that number to the phrase days in February so I see 28 days in February on the screen. So we have to do what's called type conversion. Get used to this. You're going to see it a lot in your code. It's going to come up all over the place. So all we have to do for Python is to convert any data type to a string. You just call the string function. So we call the str function. We pass it days in February, which is currently a number. And now it's going to treat that as a string. And now we say, oh, you want to concatenate string plus another string? I know what to do. Put those together and displays our message on the screen correctly. So string function is going to save you a lot when you start working with numbers and strings, mixing the two up. Now, when I do this, I'm actually storing a number as a string. And as soon as you store a number as a string, that also creates some interesting effects. So if I take a first number and I store the number 5 in it, if I put quotes around that number 5, it now treats it as a string that contains the number 5. And second num is equal to 6, a string that contains number 6. Well, what happens when you concatenate two strings together with a plus sign? It puts the two strings together, so I get 56. Well, here you can kind of see what's going on, but sometimes this is happening back behind the scenes and it'll catch you. Let's say you're using that clever input function to ask a user to enter a value. Turns out the input function will always return a string. So if you ask a user to enter a number and they enter 5, and then you enter a second number, and they enter 6. And then you say, let's print out the result of first number plus second number. It's going to print out 56. So just like earlier, I needed a way of saying, hey, I know you think it's a number, but I want you to treat it like a string. Sometimes you have a number stored in a string, and you need to treat it like it's a number. I want to do math with it. So there's a different data type conversion. Data type conversion, changing from one data type to another. So last time I was using string to convert from number to string. Now I need to use something to convert from string to number. And I have two choices of functions to work with here. The int function will convert it into an integer, a whole number, 1, 2, 3, 4. Float will convert it into a number, a floating number, or something that might have decimal places, 1.0, 1.5, 2.6, anything like that would be a float. So by using the int function, if I say print integer version of first number plus integer version of second number, or float plus float, you can see it actually does the math correctly and adds 5 plus 6 together and gives me 11. So be very careful when you're working with numbers to make sure it's using it as a correct data type at the right time. And if you're wondering what other situations you might be using numbers in, well, there's basically two situations. One, you're doing math operations to calculate salaries, calculate tax, and so on. And the other place you're going to run into numbers is when we start getting into things like arrays and lists, and you might need to point to an index value. Say, start at this position, go to this position, or go to this row here. You'll find numbers useful for that as well. So, let's step back from this and go take a look at numbers in code.